This is Cameron, and welcome to the Practice Log. It's a very special episode, actually. Hasn't been a special one in a while. Well, let's go ahead and get to the chair, and I will explain myself. See you there. Oh man, what do we have to do today? Well, first off, I've made some updates with my practice. So I went on this whole thing how I, like, wasn't gonna use my left hand anymore. And then I bought this, and I think this is really exactly what I needed. I think this is going to solve all my problems. So we're practicing again. I don't care. I know. I went 2 practice sessions without using my left hand. That's enough for me. I accept my fate. I don't care. Yeah, so you know, we're gonna be wearing this cool little sleeve for a while. I got it in green, which is the color of my text that I use. Yeah, but today we're also gonna be looking at the guitar submission competition. Hold on. Whoa, sorry about that. I didn't mean to be wearing socks for that announcement. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I spent an episode making 2 Halo guitars. I used the Halo Guitar website to, like, build a guitar, because they let you do that. And some of you have submitted your own Halo guitars, and I'm going to rate them and review them and see how they are. I'm going to judge them off of several criteria. I think the first one will be, like, the guitar itself. Style points, the name. Each guitar should be named. How much it fits your personality that I know about. Because, you know, if you leave comments, I kind of learn your personality after a while, so how well the guitars fit that'll be factored in. And last is wild card. That's how we're judging this thing, and I will tally that up at a score of 50, and whoever gets closest to 50 wins. And you know what, while we're doing it, I think I'll go ahead and make a community post with an option for each one, and we'll see what the fan favorite is too. So there'll be the Sorehands favorite, fan favorite, yeah, or something like that. Well, so we're gonna do all that, and then I'm going to practice today. It feels fine. Ooh, my nails are short. We're gonna go to the computer, and we're gonna get this show started. Well, let's go ahead and jump into it, shall we? Back to it. Man, I haven't sat down at this computer in a while. All right, so this is actually my first time looking at the guitar contest submissions. I was told that I should start at the very beginning, so I'm gonna try to do that. All right, so I have it open. I haven't looked at any of them yet. So we're just gonna scroll through this thing, and we're gonna see what we get. You guys remember the criteria that I said? Please enter your guitar creations here. I will not look at this channel until I'm ready to make the video. That is right now. I wanna be surprised. Will I be surprised? Final submissions June 9th. It is now June 11th. I'm a little late. I had an injury. Well, let's just start it off. John Yang's guitar creation. This one is titled No Mercy. I'll show a picture in case this is, like, horrible to look at. No Mercy. Pretty solid name. I'll give that, like, a 7. 7 out of 10. Now, I appreciate the build. So you have, like, the neck, the pointy neck. That's nice. Fan fret. There's a whole fan fret debacle. I see that you're going with the fan frets. That's good. Yeah, and this design is very interesting. Now, in terms of playability, which that was not one of the criteria, I don't know how useful this guitar would be, but it does definitely look cool. Ooh. Now, I'm gonna have to deduct some points on this. It does not have extended range. It looks like you only have 22 frets on this thing. I feel like No Mercy should be a 24 fret guitar, personally. I feel like that's gonna have to be some points off for this sort of guitar. I'm sorry to do it. All right, so everything finalized. I didn't go through all the categories because I forgot them all. But out of 50, I will give this guitar 36 points out of 50 for this one. And that's just my personal rating. You guys can argue about it in the comments. That's where I'm at with this one. Moving on. Okay. Alright, so this one's from Tyler. This is a pretty interesting one. Is that a picture that you uploaded yourself? I think it might be. That's not like a stock paint job, is it? That's pretty good. There are a few things that I really like about it. Alright, well, first off, the name. The name has a freaking accent mark in it. Diguelo? Diguelo is a Spanish noun. You're doing that just to mess with me. Digaller? Oh, to describe the action of throat cutting? Oh, dude, sick, bro. That's a nice name. Oh, apparently it's a ZZ Top album. Oh, okay, I see where you got it from. All right, big ZZ Top fan, huh? Still, pretty cool name, gotta admit.
Diguello.
Diguello. I love that name. That's a 10 out of 10 name. Well, first off, so I guess the imagery of that with throat cutting, it's red, it's white. It looks like a barnyard door or something. Yeah, and then the neck is very nice. It has this, like, textured, like, layered thing that matches the head. God, I gotta say, that thing's gonna be freaking hard to play. I can't even tell how many frets it has, because it's like, what am I supposed to start at 0? 1, 2, 3, 4. Like, where's the 12th fret, you know? I mean, God help you if you're trying to play anything on this. So in terms of that, I think we're gonna have to deduct some points on that one. I'm sorry. Usually, this would be a deduction. You only got one freaking pickup on that thing. Just the bridge. But that's a pretty, like, unhinged guitar to just have a bridge. But for Diguello, I think it matches pretty well. So yeah, I like that. Is that how Telecaster pickguards usually are? Hold on. Oh, you got like a special pickguard on there. You got like a half pickguard. So I'm liking that. Six strings. That makes sense. It is a Telecaster. We're not going too crazy here. Looks like that might just be a standard tremolo. That's all normal stuff. Absence of a flippy thing, of course. One volume, one tone, I presume. Yeah, and then that's it. And man, this isn't your fault. I hate that they have to put the Halo name on this guitar. Like, I feel like if you're making a custom guitar, it's like, I don't want anything to do with your freaking brand, Halo. Let me pay to remove that, please. But yeah, all in all, I gotta give this one, because it's only the second guitar, I don't want to rate it too highly, but I do really like this one. I'm gonna give it a 42. 42 out of 50. I think that's pretty fair. I might revise that to like a 43 or 44 later on, depending on where everything else is. That's a big ranking for this guitar. You should be honored. Oh, yeah. Okay, so next up is Anton the Vampire, and he's coming up in here with the Alucard. What is Alucard? Oh shoot, I just went to alucard.com. Helsing Phantom. What in the world are you doing, Anton? Oh, dude, wait, Alucard is the name from Castlevania? Is this a Castlevania name guitar? Dude, heck yeah. Is it just a like a sick name? Well, Son of Dracul or the Dragon. A fiery name for your feisty newborn? Do not name your newborn Alucard, for the love of God. Let him choose that name for himself. Oh, it's Dracula spelt backwards. I get it now. So for the name, obviously a 10 out of 10 because you're Anton the Vampire. That's like your whole thing. You're staying true to yourself and I really respect that. So you're getting mad points for that one. Now, how well that matches the name is quite well, I would say. Look at that wood grain. How much you want to bet the wood grain would come out of the factory looking like that? I would bet you $3,700 what they're trying to sell this thing for. Also, a left-handed guitar. That's minus 2 points. Yeah, so wood grain's pretty sick. We got like that natural racing stripe, pretty cool. Looks like you got a floating tremolo on that, so you can do your sick freaking squeals. That's awesome. So six strings, which makes sense for a guitar like this. This kind of reminds me of like a Schecter. It looks very Avenged Sevenfoldy. Now, one thing, looking at the fretboard, it is quite sleek. I'm not gonna know where my fingers go on that thing. There's no dots. I don't know what to do with that. I don't know why that's the thing I'm picking that deducts points. You know, I gotta fix something. Oh, and it looks like you have locking nuts as well. Locking nuts, respectable. You're really gonna be ripping that trim bar. Pretty solid. Like, you only lose points for the left-handed. You know, you couldn't know that, but... And your personality really shows through on this one. Now, the only thing that I'm kind of missing with it is it's not exactly, like, super striking in that I don't see it and I'm like, whoa. It's a solid guitar, but I feel like to get into the mid-40s or high 40s, you need to have something that really, like, is striking. And I feel like this guitar is slightly lacking that. I think for this one, I'm gonna give it a 39. And now you might hear that and you're like, what the heck? 39 is a solid score. That's a good score. And you know, honestly, what could you do to make it more striking? I don't know. Post ideas in the comments or disagree with me. Should I have given a higher score? Maybe. But I'm going with 39 for that one. Okay, let's keep it going. All right, so this one's from Last Chairbender. I'm looking at the title first, Rootin's Night Out. Okay. Let's see what we got. Whoa! Oh my god, dude. So when I was talking about, like, striking, this is a very striking guitar. My god, dude. This thing's insane. Dude, that texture looks like souls. Like, it looks like a... This thing looks like it's from Dead Space. It's crazy. Now, for the person who posted this, this is a friend of mine. He's a STEM guy. He works in STEM. Even though he's a non-guitarist, I actually see a lot of his personality in here as somebody who's very mathy. Because it's a fretless guitar. Like, this is made for, like, microtonal, like, mathy type stuff. So I feel like that's already fitting. Not only is it a fretless guitar, but it's a multi-scale fretless guitar. So you, like, really care about, like... That's like the craziest thing I've ever seen. I've never seen that. That's hilarious. Oh my god, you could use this to cut someone's head off. It looks like it's bladed at the bottom there. Truly Rootin's Night Out. I am gonna have to deduct some points for it being a multi-scale and only six strings. I feel if you really care that much about string length and like also being microtonal, you're probably gonna have more than six strings. You're gonna have like eight strings on a thing like this. This guitar looks like if you asked an alien to make you a guitar and they like just did the best they could. They're like, is that it? And it's like kinda not really. Oh my god. Dude, this thing is wacky. Oh man, it really does have the wow factor though. I have to give credit to that. Dude, the textures, god, everything just matches really well. That thing looks insane. Dude, somehow you got this thing to be almost $5,000 and you didn't put any pickups on it. Oh, that's such a blunder. There's no pickups. This is an acoustic guitar. Oh, dude, that's not good. That's some points deducted. Oh, man. I think with that, if I'm giving it a serious score, out of all the guitars I've seen, I want this one the most. And that's why I'm giving it this score, even though there's a ton of work they have to do, like adding freaking pickups to it. Like, what are the knobs controlling? They're not doing anything. With all that being said, I think I'm gonna have to give this one a 37. And I'm saying that this is my favorite guitar so far. Like, really, I really like this guitar. It's really awesome. If I got to have any of these guitars so far, it would for sure be that one. And I have a feeling it's going to be at the end of this list. It's missing pickups, though. Like, what do you even do with that? That's not good. If you had a death bar on that thing, this would be a 47, 48. Easy. But right now, 37. That's all I can give you. Come back next time. It's really close, though. I mean, I love this guitar. I mean, that thing is just so insane. My God. My God, it's awesome. All right, moving on to Neurotic Indian. The White Russian. Okay, let's see what we got. Dude, this one's coming in at 4,800. Whoa! Nice. What freaking movie is that? Is that movie just called The White Russian? I think it is. Oh, The Big Lebowski. Oh my God, is that The White Russian, the movie? All right. I've seen that movie. I'm familiar with that movie. This guitar is just themed after that movie. Okay. I think I need to start factoring this in. The freaking price. $4,800 for this guitar. Imagine, like, being in Black Veil Brides and you just come with this thing. It's like, hey guys, ready to play. Oh my God, dude. This thing is decked out with technology. First off, you went for the standard black switch, respectable. You got the like Les Paul white dials. Okay, pretty cool. Dude, you went for a Bigsby on this thing. Why? Oh my God, that's pretty great actually. It's just a stupid Floyd Rose when you, in this context, it's just a really bad Floyd Rose. Dude, and the Bigsby is gonna be grinding on the saddle here, on the metal saddle. And you know you're playing like eights on this thing too, so you can shred. Dude, those strings are not gonna last long. Oh wait, do you have extended range? I think you do. 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, 12, 23, 24, 25. 26, 27. God dang, dude. This is a Michelangelo Badio guitar right here. And it's actually shaped like one too. Wow, 27 frets. Dude, that's a lot. That's more than you need, honestly. You can hit a pretty crazy E minor chord with 27 frets. You're like a piano at that point. That's great. So like Michelangelo Badio style, but with a Bigsby. This guitar, if you're holding it, is probably so massive too, because you have that Bigsby fit in there. Like, you can see how close together all that stuff is, and then how long this thing goes out. This thing is probably huge. And I have to factor in the price. Paying $5,000 for this insane, stupid guitar. That's asking a lot. This is a $2,000 guitar. Maybe it's the Bigsby that drives it up so high. I gotta judge it fairly though. There is the meme factor with this too, with the insane choices that you made. I'm gonna give this one, I feel bad. I feel bad going lower than 35 because I feel like I've set this precedent of like only 35 plus. You're also one of my students too, so I have to like, no, you know what? You know what you're doing. This is a 25 guitar. It has to be. That's still pretty good. That's like a 50%. You know what you're doing though. This thing is really dumb. And paying that much money for it is just crazy. 25, but like lots of style points, of course. Showing up to the gig with this thing, that is just madness if you did that. All right, yeah, 25 for that one. Sorry. Okay, next up. I wonder how many of these we have. I've been like taking my sweet time. Okay, let's keep this show going. All right, next up is DK Sax. Whoa, dude, you got this thing for cheap. That's still a $3,000 guitar. That's so expensive. Okay, well, first off, it has no name, so I'm gonna call it the DK Saxocaster. We'll start there, which that name actually gives you some points, so you're welcome. All right, so we got like a nice finish on this thing. Solid guitar. I gotta say, 24 frets on a guitar like this is a little odd. I'm not gonna deduct points for it, but I will point it out. Like, I feel like the person playing this guitar cares way more about tone than like the range of their instrument, you know what I'm saying? Maybe I'll deduct like 1 point for that, sorry. Colors are nice. Like smoky blue, gotta love it. Blue's my favorite color. Into like a reverse sunburst, is that what they call this when it's like black on the edges? We got a nice pick guard on this thing. You actually have some pickups in it. That's good. Not all of us made it that far. We got three knobs. and they're silver. You match the knobs. That's good. And we got to give you some points for this. You got dots on the fretboard, so when I look over, I can actually see where my fingers are going to go. Nice. And I can easily tell that it's a 24 fret, which is a bonus. Now, as far as matching your personality, I think it's like halfway there. It's hard for me to gauge it exactly. I guess I could see this guitar being like very jazz fusion-y, like especially with the extended range. So I guess, yeah, it does match. I'm gonna give you like 75% of the credit for that part, because I think you mostly got it. And there's nothing about it that's really like jumping out at me. It's a very safe guitar, but that's also counterbalanced by the fact that it's like not insanely priced. It's just, it's only $3,000. This guitar better be freaking nice for $3,000, because I have a guitar very similar to this that was like $500. So I'm saying that like that guitar doesn't stick out that much. That guitar is basically exactly this guitar. Like, it's very similar. Now, if I purchased that guitar, do I think it would play better than my PRS SE? It might. It might play better. All that being said, I'm gonna give this one a 35. I sit well with that. 35. All right, moving on. Oh, Jay. This might be a little soon for this, but this one's called Dusty. Oh my god. Dude, whoa. Wait, did you use that? Jeez. Dude, you used freaking stolen clip art for the ladybug. I can see the brand. Yeah, Pixel, like whatever the stock footage brand is. That has to be some deduction. That's really funny. Wow. Dusty. This is a great guitar. Obviously, style points and name, like 10 out of 10 for both of those. This is a guitar that's very close to my heart, and it's still a little sensitive about it. Lots of polka dots, lots of dots in the fretboard. That's looking good. I like that. 22 fret, which like it shouldn't be more than that. I don't think it's a hollow body. This is a jazz box. Got your standard bridge there, you know, standard pickups, it looks like. Solid build. But again, we've seen some incredible guitars today. And this one, I feel like some more attention to detail could have been taken with some of the other stuff. Like maybe a green fretboard, like it's on a leaf. I don't know. I'm just throwing out ideas here. So all that being said, I think this one, I hate to say it, but this one, again, firmly has to be 35. Yeah, and I can live with that. If it had a green neck, it would be like a 40. It would be a 40, 42, easy. But I just feel like some more attention could have been taken everywhere else. That's just my opinion, though. I mean, we're gonna see what everybody else thinks. It might be a fan favorite. Definitely got the most reaction. 5 heart, 3 skulls, 4 ladybugs, 4 strawberries, which, yeah, and then 3 crying laughies. So that's pretty good. I only saw like some of the colors, but all right, I think this is the last one, but this is Mourning Dove. This one's called The Siren. Let's see what we got. Oh my god. Whoa, okay, hold on.
Oh wow.
That's a lovely guitar. I am speechless. I mean, that is just, I was not expecting that at all. Wow. Okay, well, so let's go through a few things here. First off, this is late stage sore hands right here. Long hair. So you drew this recently. Cool. Nice hands, by the way. You did a good job with the hands. Really interesting colors. It's mermaid themed, of course. I'm seeing that with the siren. I like the build. I think this is called the Jaguar or something like that. I don't know. The neck color, really nice, really matches the whole siren theme. Blue headstock, really nice. Gold tuning nuts. 7 strings. That's flattering. Thank you. One thing, only a neck pickup? I don't think I've ever seen that before. Like, this is a jazz guitar, is what you're telling me. So this is my jazz guitar. And not even like jazz fusion, this is my jazz guitar. my god. Yeah, I think for like style, like obviously 10 out of 10. For personality, I think this does reflect your personality with like the silliness. Wow, mother of pearl fretboard too for that. I mean, really, the theming is definitely 10 out of 10. Effort, again, 10 out of 10. That neck pickup is really bugging me though. That's insane. That's a crazy choice. That's like the most unhinged thing I've seen all day. An only neck pickup guitar. I have to say I love it. Like, I do love it. I really do. I'm more in shock than anything. This is probably the reaction you're going for. Just me being like, what in the world am I looking at right now? You know, when I started this YouTube channel, I never would have imagined that it would come to this. I mean, it's all really good. Like, it's all perfectly themed. I mean, the gold accents. Okay, I need to move past it. So this guitar, it's gonna get a high rating, because I mean, obviously, you know how to appeal to me, put my face on it with like a hand-drawn thing. I like that. I do have a YouTube channel, after all. I am pretty self-involved. This is... Wow. I'm gonna give it a 43, and only because I feel weird giving it anything higher than that. Like, if I give this one the 50, it's like, what's that saying about myself? Like, yep, this is the best guitar out of all of them. Okay, well, that was that. That was a good one to end it on. This one and Jay, definitely, it looked like they both tied with the fan favorite for attention. Thank you to everyone who posted your guitar. I think they're all winners, in my opinion. I'm gonna have to leave this one up to all the viewers to see what the real winner is. I'm not even gonna pick a winner, I just rated them. I gave you all the ratings. I can't pick a winner. It's like picking my favorite child. But wow, okay, let's leave this. Okay, I have all the images saved so you can see them as you just saw them already. I of course need to process some of those. But yeah, really awesome work. Good job, guys. All right, I've been filming this part for a while.
What the heck?
Let's go ahead and make our way to the piano bench. Man, I almost forgot that I'm injured. I'm gonna be fine though. I'm gonna practice today anyways. I don't care. I'll see you there. You know, this is a good video to just get back to normal with, because that's what we're doing. We're just getting back to the normal grind because I'm gonna practice. So I will see you on the other side. Okay, how about this? I'm gonna keep practicing, but I think the piece I'm gonna play tonight is Morel Sonatina Movement 2. I'm fine, I'm healed up. Don't leave a comment about it. Let me bring you closer. I'm gonna play through it, and then that'll be my playing for the night. And then I'm gonna keep practicing, because I've really only worked on that. I'd like to work on my other music. I'm having a good time. My hand's feeling pretty good. I'm pressing down with a lot less pressure. It's time for me to take these weights off. Oh, like an anime character. Now I can really play Morel Sonatina Movement 2. Thank you. I flubbed some parts that I didn't expect to flub. My hair kept getting, like, way too in my face. I'm gonna try that one more time. Alright, well, the second time, I got all the slow stuff pretty good. I didn't have any, like, blunders in it like I did the first time. You're gonna hear the first time, though, because I completely blundered the fast part. So that's what that's telling me. Like, I just need to work on that fast part and just get it, like, really solid. So, you know, that's what we got there. We are practicing some more. You know what? I think now is a good time to stop, for no reason in particular. No, I'm feeling fine. Today is my first day, like, kind of back to it. I've been taking it real easy the past week. My thumb does feel okay. Like, obviously, if I put a lot of pressure on it, I get that feeling. But just, like, lightly pressing, it's been okay. And this is actually helping a lot, just to kind of put some pressure on it, just to kind of hold it in place. This is gonna be my life for a little while. I think it's gonna be okay. Yeah, we'll see. We'll see where we end up in the next week or so. Okay, this has been going on for quite a while. I didn't practice for that long, but you know the deal. I'll practice more later, and I'll play my newer pieces for you later, too. Let's go ahead and wrap it up. I'll see you in the outro. Hey, well, you know, if you made it this far, be sure to subscribe and leave a like. Hey, want some guitar lessons? I offer those. Just send me an email, and I'll give you some guitar lessons. Running through it. Got any comment questions? Feel free to leave a comment question. That was a pretty fun competition. Do you guys like doing stuff like that? I can try to find more stuff like that if you want. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap it up because I want to go to bed and all that stuff. But I'll see you tomorrow morning and we'll get Bach to the Bach, which I'm excited about because I haven't practiced Bach in a few days. Alright. I'll see you tomorrow.